He brought something new to the drum stool. And Mitchell's influence continues to be felt in 2008. By his own calculation, Seb Rochford anchors 8 different jazz-cum-rock combos, as well as being an in-demand session player. He's recorded his own interpretations of the Hendrix and Mitchell songbook.
He sort of took influences from jazz drummers like Elvin Jones and Max Roach and people like that, and sort of incorporated into jazz.
And he brought that into rock.
Yeah, so he would do sort of the same sort of fills and stuff, but with the rock things over.
The other thing about the Jimi Hendrix experience, and it was almost unknown in the late 60s, even in rock and roll circles, was that it was a multiracial band. They used to hang out together even in the kitchen, by Mitchell's own account.
You've always had a guitar with him, anywhere you went. To the bathroom. I saw him literally one day doing eggs and bacon in the kitchen, still with a guitar slung around his back, frying some eggs and bacon up. Oh. Wait a minute, I think I've got... That was the kind of person he was.